They are talk about SYSML meta model using SBC process algebra. Chapter 1 discuss inconsistency between SYSML different diagram. There are many inconsistency between this nine system ML diagrams. What is the purpose of SYSML meta model? We need SYSML meta model to ensure or to assure the consistency between these different diagrams. Chapter 3 discuss about current approaches of SYSML meta model. There are many approaches, such as OCL or meta object plasticity or foundational UML or action language for foundational UML as the SYSML meta model. However, there are deficiencies of current SYSML meta model. First, they all are so complex. Second, they all do not integrate the static structure and the dynamic behavior. Now, let's go for SBC process algebra. First, we say SBC stands for structural behavior coalescence. Secondly, we say SBC process algebra integrate the structure and behavior. Third, we will say SBC process algebra will be the core semantics of SYSML. There are many entities in the SBC process algebra, such as G1, G2 for type 1 interaction, V1, V2 for type 2 interaction. A1, A2 means type 1 or type 2 interaction, such and such. The signature for an operation is a combination of its name along with parameters. And each parameter in the list is displayed with direction, parameter name, and parameter type. Type 1 interaction means actor interact with a CoE block with operational call or return, and the operational or call return signature. Type 2 interaction is an interaction between the caller block and the CoE block with operational call signature or operational return signature. We use three rules to describe the syntax of SBC process algebra. The first rule shows a system is a summation of many IFD. The second rule shows an IFD is a process prefixed with type 1 interaction and many type 1 or 2 interaction. Then the third rule describes the type 1 or type 2 interaction is either a type 1 interaction or a type 2 interaction. Let's discuss about the semantics of SBC process algebra. The fourth process, empty process stop, is a valid SBC process. That means this empty process. The second process, like prefix process A dot E, means that it will perform the interaction A, then continue like process E. The third rule, the summation process E1 plus E2 means it can proceed either as the process E1 or the process E2. Now let's go to the summary of SBC process algebra. A system is defined as a summation of many IFD with stop, or we can show as G11 dot A12 dot A13, then summation, the second IFD G21 dot A22 dot A23, and more IFD. We can use Baker's null form tree to describe a system's process. A system contain many IFD, and each IFD is displayed as the tree. So we use the SBC transition graph to describe a system. That's the only one diagram represent the semantics of a system. A system, the initial state is a system. From system, you can go to the state E111 with the transition. That's G11 interaction. Then from E111 to state E112 with the transition interaction A12, such and such. So we have many IFD in this transition graph of a system. Then we use a table to as a supplement to describe the interaction in the transition graph. So here we show all the interaction of this system. G11 has a caller, is actor 1, what then the operational call channel 2, 11, and the call block is block 11, such and such. Finally, we have the conclusion. SBC process algebra does integrate the static structure and dynamic behavior. Secondly, SBC process algebra is very simple without much complexity. Also, all SYSML diagram can be produced from the SBC process algebra, no matter its block definition diagram, internal block diagram, or use case diagram, activity diagram, such and such, all can be projected from SBC process algebra. This diagram, this graph shows SBC process algebra is the meta model of SYSML. Also, SBC process algebra really ensures consistency between all SYSML diagrams.